Roger, 65. Here we go. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome on board the Grouse Mountain Super Sky Ride. It's going to take us 8 minutes to get to the chalet, which is 3,700 feet or 1,100 meters above the city of Vancouver, which you can see coming into view across the tree line there in the beautiful sunshine today. In just a moment, we're going to pass over our timber wolf habitat, which is home to 3 timber wolves, a gray alpha male and 2 white pack members. This time of day, sometimes they're a little tricky to see. They can be hiding in the bushes sometimes. There is a viewing platform down there. The entrance to that platform is just across the parking lot from the Red Sky Ride, so you can go get a close-up look at the wolves on your way back down. They were born and raised for film and television, and then their acting careers didn't work out, so they needed a place to stay. We adopted them in 2004. There's a few things that are complimentary with your ticket today. On the first floor of the chalet is the Theater in the Sky, where there's 3 different shows being presented. The first is Born to Fly, which is a brief history of Grouse Mountain, along with an aerial view of southwestern British Columbia from an eagle's perspective. That's every hour on the hour. Every hour on the half hour, we're showing the Discovery Channel's Extremely Wild, which talks about our grizzly bears, Grinder and Kula, and their journey here in 2001. And lastly, as part of our Remarkable Raptors program, we've got a documentary called Taito's Triumph, which talks about our barn owl, Taito, and the need to preserve owl habitats. Check that out, or take a guided nature walk, which will show you owl habitats here on the mountain firsthand. So for information on that or anything else you might want to see or take in while you're here, you can go to guest services, Alpine Guest Services on the first floor of the chalet, and they can help you out with anything you might need. Now, coming into view below us here is the man-made Capilano Lake. This supplies Metro Vancouver with about a third of its total drinking water supply. It's contained on the left-hand side down there by the Cleveland Dam, which was built in 1952. Now, if you look up to the head of the valley, you can see those 2 twin peaks up there. They used to be called the Sisters, but in the 1920s, their names were changed to the Lions. They are the tallest peaks on the North Shore at 5,400 and 5,200 feet above sea level. Looking back down towards the ocean, you can just see the Lionsgate Bridge there, which spans the entrance to the Burrard Inlet, one of the largest harbors on the West Coast. The bridge itself empties into the 1,000 acres of Stanley Park. To the left of Stanley Park, where all those high-rise buildings are, that's the core of downtown Vancouver. The population of the greater Vancouver area is just over 2.3 million people. On the waterline downtown, that building with the white sails on top is the Canada Place cruise ship terminal, which brings in about 1 million passengers every year by the end of October. Something most people don't know is that there's 1 sail for every province and territory in the country of Canada on top of Canada Place. So there you go, you learned something new. To the right of Stanley Park, where all those boats are anchored out there, that's known as English Bay, and that peninsula beyond it is Point Grey, which is home to the University of British Columbia. That large body of water in the distance is the Strait of Georgia, and then way up across the water, that land out there is Vancouver Island. In just a second, we're going to pass over the first of 2 towers on our trip, and when we do, the tram is going to sway a little bit, so you may wish to steady yourself. This will also be our halfway point up the mountain. You'll also see the other cable car coming downhill on my side over here. Here they come. There they go. People often ask me if the car going downhill travels faster than the car going uphill, which makes sense when you see it going by. It does look like it's going a little faster, but it's all an illusion. We're attached to a gigantic loop of cables, so we exit the stations at the same time and travel at the same speed. We're going 4 meters a second right now, which is roughly 15 kilometers an hour. If you guys have any questions, my name is Nick. Don't hesitate to ask. Otherwise, enjoy the ride.
C'est pas grave, on reviendra plus ici, on a 40
décaps. 81.
Regarde dehors au lieu de te discuter.
Stand by. Downhill load is 65. Roger.
We were maybe 30 seconds behind.
And so...
Okay, back to three.
Hard to say.
Ladies and gentlemen, in just a second, we're going to pass over the second tower, and the tram is going to sway a little bit more than it did last time, so you will want to steady yourself. And you'll see the chalet, which is home to the award-winning Observatory Restaurant, open for reservations from 5 p.m. nightly. Next door to that is the more casual Altitude Bistro. And also, you'll find the Lupin's Cafe, Crossbody Cock Bar, Outfitters Gift Shop, and Spirit Gallery. So lots of great stuff in there. We've got a huge sale on right now at Outfitters, so you can get up to 50% off all of our great alpine gear from big-name brands like Arc'teryx, Columbia, Merrill, DNA, and more. So you can go out to Outfitters on the first floor of the chalet and check that out. It'll be on, the sale will be on until tomorrow, so if you're a Y2Play pass holder or an annual membership holder, and you see something you think a friend would like, well, you can come back and bring a friend for free, so check out the sale. If you want information on anything to see and do up here, like ziplining or the lumberjack show or helicopter tours or anything like that, you can go to guest services and they will help you out. The tickets that you use to get up here, you need those tickets to get back down, so don't throw them away. They're very important. And lastly, we are proud to be British Columbia's first entirely smoking-free resort, so we thank you in advance for your cooperation and welcome to Ground Mountain, the peak of Vancouver.